Like, that strain? You ever heard of that life? It's a new strain.
Good evening, good evening, good evening. Y'all make some noise, make some noise. Y'all excited tonight for some poetry, make some noise. Alright, just leave my boys right here. You know, you can't be the champ without an entourage, you know what we're doing. Appreciate that. My name is Ecclesius Guerriere. I go by Cle. I also go by Champ. That's my stage name. Y'all make some noise for me. I kind of need that. Little quick note. I got my boy in the audience. He's actually judging, but a lot of y'all used to see me around campus, but y'all haven't seen me in a while because I'm always at work. And yeah. Yeah, clap it up for having a job. Yep. Having a job. Yep. So the other day he has a band and everything, and like they like do jazz, a jazz bar and everything. So I come out there and he like, shout out to my boy Clee, he works at Walmart. Yeah, that wasn't cool. That was not cool. He like, you need discounts, Black Friday, hit him up. That was not cool. I love you though, man. I love you though. But I'm the former president of Poetic Lyricism. I am the creator of the poetry slam that you guys are at right now. Yep. Not to pat myself on the back, but you know, a lot of other things, you know. SGA, you know, SGA, BSU. And my brothers right here, PBM, shout out. And my brothers out here. We're gonna keep the show rolling tonight. Like that's my main thing. Our theme for tonight is Apollo's cup, and it's pretty much a Greek thing. So you know, who better to have a Greek? I'm not Greek, but you know, I guess I was born Greek because I have a Greek first name. So it's like yeah. Yeah. They'd be like, hey Clee, why ain't go Greek? Because I'd be like, I was born Greek, you know? So hey. Yeah, so any Greeks in the house, by the way? Shout out to the Catholics. Can y'all do what y'all do? Shout out to the Catholics. That's it. I thought you was gonna shimmy, you know, do all that. And they wait for you, man. Ah, there you go, there you go. It is. There it is. Show it out, sorry. There you go. That's how you represent the campus. Shout out to Sigma Gamma Rho, Sorority Incorporated. Shout out to the Bruhs, the Qs, any of y'all here?
Free
They'll be back soon enough. They'll be back. All right, some of them are suspended right now, so yeah. I'm just saying. All right, if y'all don't know my personality, I might say some stuff today. So I guess deltas, y'all be back. Fall, y'all in my heart. All right, we got any sigmas in the house? Damn, what's going on? Damn. All right, we got any AKAs in the house? All right, Kevin, Alphas. All right, he put his phone up. All right, shout out. Iotas. Really? All right, so I guess Indiana Love is holding it down tonight. Indiana Love is holding it down tonight. So shout out to y'all, man. Who are my sponsors, man? FSU. I guess y'all don't have a call. It's a publication. My bad. FAMU. Wait. Don't yell. That's what I was expecting. All right. Quiet down. So, Seminoles, that's what happened. Messed up how y'all sitting apart from each other, so that's kind of messed up. But what I was trying to say is the little chant that y'all were doing, I guess that's what happens when you get hazed up a lot. All right. Y'all know it's all love. All right. But anyways, me and my entourage, we about to get up off stage. We about to introduce the teams. So they about to come up one by one. So I want y'all to really show some love for all the teams who will be performing tonight. All right, so y'all show them some love. DJ, go ahead and hit the intro music.
Church girl. but I won't vomit Jesus on you now.
I'm the stereotype of a little innocent girl, but I'm a lesbian. I'm the stereotype of a child raised by a single mother, but I don't got daddy problems.
Shame. I'm the stereotype of a black male, but knowledge is power.
And I'm Nate Watts.
And this is stereotype.
Operation Face.
And I'm a Y'all give it up for all the performers tonight. Y'all give it up for all the performers tonight. Two times for myself, for the crew in the building, man. Danny, kind of Lauderdale, Palm Beach, man. My Tampa Bay crew in the building, Orlando. What is it? Hold on.
Check, check, check. All right, Danny County in the house. Y'all gotta come harder than that. Y'all gotta come harder than that. Danny County in the house. See what I'm talking about? See what I'm talking about? Have you? See what y'all talking about? Alright. Don't make me suspend y'all. Alright. Lauderdale in the house, Lauderdale. Tampa. Palm Beach. Duval. Shout out to Tallahassee for all my locals. Orlando. Alright, I gotta do this. New York. Texas. Alright, I got two more. California. Georgia. Hey. Alright. We about to go into the judge introductions.
Hey, what about Haiti?
I ain't get a shout out to him, man. Hey, real serious y'all. I just want to get a quick shout out to a personal friend of mine. He just went through something very difficult. He overachieved. My boy Barack Obama, you know. Two times for Obama. Y'all make some more.
Two times!
All right. I should have some fun, y'all. Have some fun. All right, we're going to introduce our judges. And judges, I'm going to ask you to stand up when I introduce you. First and foremost is my boy Truth. Please take a stand. Alright, he sent me this really long text message, bio, but I'm going to read it. Truth is originally from Houston, Texas. He has been writing poetry for over 13 years and has performed in over... and has performed in countless shows in his life thus far. TRUTH, acronyms, is an acronym meaning two things between them, and the higher power is, oh, that's a good one. And the higher, I guess that's a duh, right? That's a duh. Okay, it's a misspell. It says he, I caught it, alright? English major. Alright. And the higher power is the root and the reality of overcoming the hurt. Truth, I should have read this first, my bad, man. The hurt is be real truth. Alright, receiving his bachelor's of science in theater from FAMU. Truth has learned to transform himself in the minds of tomorrow through continued
Alright, we'll continue.
Alright, that's supposed to be continuous or continuous? Through continuous performances centered around Elevation Truth. Had two Spark Award CDs and it's been a part of Black on Black Rhyme for 7 years. All in all, truth lives by the motto, there is one shot at freedom, pull the trigger. Alright, so he says there's one shot at freedom, so pull the trigger. Y'all give it up for Truth. My bad, man. You got an iPhone, so it does the auto spell correct thing. I feel you, man. That wasn't me, y'all. Y'all can read this. All right. Next up is my boy Phil. Stand up, Phil. All right. Philip Scott, a Tampa, Florida native. Is a Hall of Fame member of Poetic Lyricism, make some noise. Phil has been the slam coach slash slam master of Black on Black Rhyme slam teams for the past 4 years. Phil has also been a performer at Busch Gardens Africa in Tampa, a member of the Marching 100. I'm not gonna say nothing about that. And Phil has performed. Phil has performed in U.S. tours, including Japan, with a stage production for from Drumline. Okay, he now plays with a band called Groove Square at the High Five Jazz Club. Y'all give Phil some love. All right, next up is Miss Laquisha Smith. Alright, Quisha is a fourth-year sociology major from Orlando, Florida. She is the founder of Voices, FAMU's poetry group, and a member of Black on Black Rhyme, the Yemwa Dance Company, and Black on Black Rhyme Dancers. Give it up for Quisha. Last but not least is my boy Mike T. Y'all give him some love. Michael Theodore, aka Mike T, is from the legendary city of West Palm Beach, Florida. He is a graduating senior, former vice president of Poetic Lyricism, former membership chair of Progressive Black Men, also a former SGA senator. So y'all give Mike some love, and he's also majoring in African American Studies, sociology, and he is a future lawyer, filmmaker, and world-renowned poet. So y'all give Mike some love. And Mike has a poem about everything. Y'all know. Yeah, he does. He really does. All right. Now, we're about to go into our first performance of the night. Now, if y'all are not familiar with slam poetry typically goes on something called PSI rules. And basically the way that it works is time starts whenever the poets up here make a sound. And the time limit is 3 minutes with a 10-second grace period. And the way that judging goes is there are going to be a total of five judges, because I introduced four of them. But I'll let y'all know the surprise afterward. But there's five judges, and the highest and the lowest scores are dropping, and three middle scores are average. Y'all got that? Mm-hmm. Highest and lowest draw. So if anybody give anybody lower than a 9, I want y'all to boom. Yeah. All right? Boom like crazy, all right? Anything lower than a 9, all right? Now, what we normally do at Poetry Slams is to get the audience in the flow of things. We have a sacrificial poet come up first. And that's just a test run so y'all can see how things are gonna go for the duration of the night, all right? Now, before I do that, though, let me get somebody from this side, raise your hands. All right. If you're not performing, non-performers. Orange hat? Orange and brown? All right, come on.
It's okay.
All right, she's gonna introduce herself. You don't mind? She's gonna introduce herself. All right, go ahead.
I'm Cameron Hawkins.
Hey.
Hey, Cameron.
Oh, Cameron Hawkins.
Where you from?
Oh, y'all don't know where I'm from. Y'all gonna take from me, so I don't wanna say where I'm from. Oh, I'm from Jasper, Florida. I go up here at D. Florida State University. I am double major in criminology and sociology.
And who'd you vote for?
I voted Romney because I'm gonna be a huge millionaire.
All right, ignore that, y'all. Ignore that. But, all right, so this is how we're going to do it. Like I said, we had a surprise. So Cameron over here is going to be our fifth judge for tonight. So if you can take a seat right over there at the judge's table. How we doing? All right, Andre. Where's Andre? Andre's about to come up. He's going to be our sacrificial poet.
Gonna beat
the money. I see you, boo!
Yes, Andre!
Andre! Go ahead, poet!
Set the mic.
Here you go.
Thank
My mom never told me that the god of love is a woman having her period and yeast infection at the same time. She never told me that my dream of becoming the first African-American homosexual Republican judge in the state of Tennessee is probably impossible. She never told me that the saying joy comes in the morning is just an old cliche, but that morning joy is by definition an oxymoron. She forgot to tell me that all promises have expiration dates, or that everybody lies, and that she's no exception because she could look me in my eyes at 12 and tell me that her and my dad would never separate, but 4 years later, she could look me in my eyes again and tell me that they were as if she never made that promise at all. She forgot to tell me that girls could gargle their own blood while their rapist pushed their fist so far down her throat while his dick as far, while her rapist pushes her his fist so far down her throat as his dick in her stomach. She forgot to tell me that that girl could be my own sister, that rape didn't only happen on TV, and that years would pass and rape would still be the topic of all my poetry. She forgot to tell me that guilt would consume me because I was shopping while she was gang raped in a band room. She forgot to mention that God could leave me crying like a 4-year-old on the first day of school and on my hands and knees like an alcoholic, I'd throw up, screaming, yelling, praying all in one breath to a God I'd later find out has no ears. No ears to hear me say that I'm confused, that there's just too much that I did not know, because my mom never told me that God's plans and my plans are never the same, or that his plans are always better for me than my own. She forgot to tell me that I could be the only black person in the class of 500. Forgot to tell me that a white guy in my literature class could come dressed as George Zimmerman for Halloween and think that that was funny. Forgot to mention that my chances of getting cancer before turning 25 is somewhere near 80% because it runs on both sides of her family and one side of my dad, and finals won't be the hardest thing that I go through in my senior year in college. My mom forgot to tell me that while everybody's in the moon on Wednesday nights, I'd be begging God that this chemo be my last. There's just so much that I did not know. I'm less educated than Laura Hill, so we'll call this piece the miseducation of Andre Johnson. But if my mom's biggest fault is protecting me too much, then I guess I'd rather not have it any other way. And everybody said she was too straight, that I'd grow up and I'd be wild, but no, I stand before you today proud to say that I've never been on the inside of a club, that the taste of alcohol is unfamiliar to my tongue, not a sip, not even one, that in a world where boys run trains at 14 and girls bust it wide open at their sweet 16s, in my 21 years, virginity has been innately a part of me. I am what a God's child would have been had he not been part God. I am a different breed of human, and I never take part in activities unbecoming of a member of the court, because on that day that my name becomes Andre Johnson, J.D., Andre Johnson, Esquire, Andre Johnson, attorney at law, Andre Johnson, judge, I'll have no regrets. And I owe it all to the many things that my mom never taught.
Alright, judges, y'all ready? Alright, judges, hold up your scores. Alright, scores from lowest to highest. We got a 7.5. We have an 8.6. We got a 9. We got a 9. We got a 9.1. You got a total score, y'all? Y'all got that average? All right, so that's an average score of a 26.6. All right, that's a good score, good score. Clap it up. All right. All right, we're gonna get into our groups. The first group up to the stage to rock the mic, y'all give it up for Operation Face.
This is my weapon. There's only one like it. Through the barrel, I got back and spit knowledge. My piece is the instrumental tool of revolution. To only allow individual voices to be heard. Only to be used to pressure poets to bust back. Now poets, bust back. I said poets, bust back.
Ignorance and stupidity be testing me like I won't pop off. They try and put a silence on me, but I still pop off. These words through these barrels, hollow tips fill all. I'm tearing through flesh, vest, souls, and all.
Black. Peep this. I'm an automatic shotgun with a long range and an ACG scope. That's a concept that shouldn't be messed with. Salute me. Mitt Romney and Sarah Palin be hobnobbing me in a conspiracy convention. I'm going to stand on the rooftop to tear the roof off and turn their scalp into a drop top. And then I'm going to empty the full clip on a whole clip on some Virginia Tech shit, because they taxing us for an education. That's not quite a blessing yet. Private corporations be privatizing my due process. So in due process, I'm going to sit them at a table and off their domes, rob their homes, murder their accountants. Watch they Netflix, fuck they bitches, break they friends, and leave their business.
AK-47 with a drill mag and a chrome silencer, so I shoot when we all listening. The smell of deteriorated flesh coming from the gas piston, and it's okay that they say I'm not consistent. But I go to the White House, kill 15 cabinet members, leave Obama, so technically I'm not missing. I cry 100 tears a minute, that's 100 deaths in 60 seconds. The Democrats and Republicans are confused, so there's no time for resting. This world is at war and these guns ain't stressing. So I wipe my tears, put on my turban, fly to Iraq, play to Allah, and teach another better lesson.
Check it out, I'm a P90 submachine gun with an LV integrated laser. Call me Fred Hampton, cause when the legs clapping, revolution happens. I'm a captain, see? I was on the balcony with Dr. King. Cop the bullet, turn around and let the chopper sing. Hit the shoot everywhere from his top to spleen. I even shot him in the throat and watch him drop his teeth. Took his arms off, said I hope he got on a good belt, cause if not, he don't drop his jeans. Then assassinate every philosopher thief from Plato to Socrates. They ain't stopping me.
We're people calling the Desert Eagle, but now I'm rousing mad as cataclysm with clips to a deadly regal.
resting up against the waist. I can hear the stomach growling from a taste of skulls. My mission is lethal. Intelligent people, aim for the head and watch the body collapse. His face in his lap, embrace for text. Find your girl and put a fade in her tracks. Wait for that. And moment you realize I'm more than a hand cannon shooting silhouettes. My thoughts are in the throat of the tech. You're playing Russian roulette. Put me away, I'm hugging your leg. Do you really want to take that bet?
Nah.
Shooting for a change in the White House. Guard your leads. Education's written on the bullets and for your kids. I'm driving through an American wasteland with a desert eagle on my waist, man. They got guns and clips, I use my tongue and lips to let loose. My phone was like a semi-automatic cooling rod because I live in the enemy, rest in peace. I use the peace to keep the peace.
One by one, in the chamber they fall. The dad, the mom, the kids, the dog. Bury them all under the laws of poetry.
What goes up must come down. We're tearing down dynasties.
Yo, all I need is one mic, one beat, one stage, one nigga from my piece, one from me, one nigga.
Alright, we're gonna keep it rolling. Judges, y'all ready? Alright, hold up the scores. Alright, scores, lowest to highest. We got an 8.2. We have an 8.5. We have an 8.9. We have a 9. We have a 9.3. All right, that's a 26.4. Y'all give it up. All right. Y'all make some noise for them real quick. All right, next up to the mic, we have Stereotype.
Today we like to take you on a journey. A journey through experience. A journey through life in every diamond, crystalline facet therein. A journey through the senses. Join us as we paint this experience for you. And the street lights pass in a comforting, monotonous rhythm. Our tempo with the song and the radio was somehow perfect.
I see headlights.
I hear the screeching of tires.
Snow burnt rubber. I feel our bodies shift and begin to swerve.
Crash. They say that right before we die, our life flashes before our eyes. Our memories are tied inseparably to our senses.
It was like that day in preschool. The headlights in the tunnel vehicle reminded me of the ray of sunlight that hit me and my father.
I believe you. How much did it cost me? Well, the price is lofty. I'm in love. Have you found me? I'm in innocence. Have you lost me? I'm your inner voice. It's this thing that you make the sinner's choice that led your fingers moist to touch. Counting keys of thought erupting in symphonic combustion of emotional eruption. And the noise between the silence. The quartet of a thousand sirens pulling you into a bed of fire, burning your ambition and replacing it with your heart's desire. Thought, distraction, yet focus. And the locust that ravages your seed of hopelessness, plaguing you with the buzzing idea that maybe you could be the dopest. I'm your fate. I am the catalyst of your fears. I'm that embedded hatred, remind me of the institutional captives that we've been conditioned to grab for years. I'm your greatest of goals, described as your soul's deepest fears. I'm the idea that fate is what brought us all here. The drum in your ears, the strumming of patience was taught you to hear. I'm that moment of reflection and I come in the form of your peers. Now who will survive and who will disappear?
Hey, real quick, shout out to Skidmore DJs.
Yo.
Dang, messed up. All right, we gonna keep it moving. Judges, let me see the scores. All right, here are your scores from lowest to highest. 6.5. Ooh. That's messed up. Whatever that is, messed up. We got a 7. We got another 7. We have an 8. And we have a 9. All right, that's a score of a 22. 22, y'all show me some love. All right, next up to the mic, we got the 18.
What happens when your guardians don't guard?
When you need to be encouraged, and there is no encouragement.
When there's no lesson on what's right and wrong, and you're rightfully wrong for your wrongdoing. Your only use is for abuse.
What happens when your best isn't good enough?
When the bar is raised higher than the capability of your lanes and adequacy seems impossible.
It's hard to feel anything but pitiful when your worth is invisible. And with parents being so critical, it's not worth it. They constantly look for ways to be deemed worthy.
Television misinformed me about the tools it takes to be a happy family.
I never saw Bill Cosby tell his kids to give up.
Even the show in the ghetto was called Good Times.
Even though every episode was just bad times.
Turning households from dynamite to fear and fright. Caring more about what they say than we say.
More I hate choosing who raised.
I feel shortchanged.
Doing what I can for some approval and some words that make me feel useful, but it seems my life is one big Achilles heel.
Despite my noteworthy accomplishments, I'll always be incarcerated to my weaknesses. My vices have me in a vice grip. I'm trying to escape this, but I promise earthquakes couldn't shake this.
Perpetual longing to be a child. That is your medal of honor that is displayed proudly in your conversations with your faction.
And if I'm feeling like Will Smith when he wrote Parents Just Don't Understand, I can hardly imagine those entangled in cobwebs of the mothers and fathers' past relationships. Children sobbing softly at night about the parents that weren't there for their birthday.
Their tears ran down their face like the wax down the candle that they just blew out.
Wishing for a better life. Wishing some of their parents were still man and wife. Going the extra step to understand the concept of stepmommies and daddies. Letting sons turn into men on their own.
Soul spiraling in the somber singularity. Praying for some sort of swift breakthrough to make sense of their existence. And their room has become a safe haven from misfits. They have all of this talent, but they might as well be giftless if you don't take any interest.
You're too concerned with the little green men in your wallet.
What happened when parents used to last for the stars closer to us so it'd be easier to reach for them?
And a child's bedroom used to be safe as a lion's den. A mother protecting her cubs.
Your children are dying to be noticed for more than what they lack. But our imperfections will always be the elephant staggering about in the room. We are doomed to the list of things we didn't do. We are always paying dues that are possible to do. Through all the beasts and fees.
The bed is a constant hiding place for this game of hide and seek with drunks and rapists.
To taste this vengeance and regret is sort of bittersweet. It's like running full speed in a landfill with landmines, bombs, grenades strapped to your feet. You can't win, you can't break even, and don't even think about getting out of the game. A man with no exit.
A slave with no sense of direction.
A war zone with no ammo or protection.
Ancient prophets never foresaw the downfall between parents and children.
This maternal outcry must be stopped. We just want to feel like we belong in your hearts.
Yeah, I'll give it up. Give it up for them fellas.
That's just ending. That's. Okay. All right. Judges.
Open those for Duval.
Alright, alright. Scores from lowest to highest, we have a 9.3. We have a 9.7. We have a 9.8. We have a 9.8. And we have a 10. This is out of 30, y'all, for an average score of a 29.3. Thank God. This is not a probate, y'all. Yeah. All right, next up to the mic. Y'all give it up for Estrogen.
If only I had
a prettier smile,
darker skin,
straighter hair,
a bigger butt,
smaller arms, arms.
Man, I don't like my smile. Teeth so crooked, it let my tongue in jail. Jesus said, instead of braces, I would need gates. And on Sunday, I had people saying,
oh, Jesus!
I put your lay hands upon my mouth.
Amen.
But even prayer couldn't work it out.
Amen.
People like folks congregating outside of church.
Preach.
But even though I'm buck teeth, ain't nobody finna drop big bucks to get my teeth fixed, though.
Man, at least you ain't get teeth for being white. Played hide and go seek and always got found. Can't throw up my fist without getting clowned. I swear, I'm black.
She mixed.
Long hair and do care.
No playtime, no playtime.
You act like my Milky Way ain't mine.
Well, at least you have a Milky Way. Cause I hate all my Kiwi ways. Cause I wish they were tamed. And my skin got craters everywhere. Like the man on the moon be walking from ear to ear. Man, I got stretch marks all up here. I got them all down here.
Girl, stretch marks.
What?
Let's talk about some serious shit. Anyway, I'm proud to be on Team Lil Booty and all. But having a big chest always leaves them disappointed. They expect something fast in the phone, my bad. Being ain't always the solution, but it's okay. Not so long ago, he once told me that being big wouldn't be easy, but shit, I feel like I was born to wear a helmet and tackle with arms of a linebacker and muscle mass I cover up with heavy jackets. Damn! I just want to rock a strapless with
who straps like Angela Bassett.
But you're not the first woman of size. So Joanna Truth was big, 6 foot in height, but 6 foot in faith. She took a white man to court and
won the case. So what you trying to say?
Maybe you have those big arms to help you carry the weight of the world.
All right, so what about the first black Secretary of State?
Ooh, Condoleezza Rice with the mean-ass gap?
Yeah, they want to bridge the gap between the White House and black. So maybe all those bucks in your teeth mean that one day you gonna have racks.
And girl, you don't have to be afraid of not being black. Look at us, we all different shades, and you bright because your future looks that way.
Don't let your hair get in the way of ignoring your roots. You have kinks in your locks because there are no kinks in your brain.
Right, and a small ass means no distractions. Men will approach you with a good head on their shoulders and not the happy head in their pants. But regardless of your flaws, you are a strong woman.
Regardless of our flaws, we are strong women.
Society focuses on our physical appearance, forgetting that we keep this world on the axis.
This is the man's world,
but we preserve the balance.
Always underestimated, but never replaced.
We make history, her story every day.
Success is a required state of mind.
Then it comes to fame. The hard work comes before anyone ever knows your name.
Trying to get to the top without putting our image to shame.
We are more than our breath and face.
We are the entire nervous system where all the action takes place. We are invincible.
Caretakers.
I like you.
Trailblazers.
And honesty.
Flawed by society.
Flawless by definition.
I already know how that song goes.
Yeah.
you gotta sing.
You gotta let me vibe back here, man. You gotta let me vibe.
Shout out Kelly. We vibing. We vibing. All right, y'all give him some love. Give him some love. All right, judges got their scores up. We're gonna go scores from lowest to highest. Wow. Lowest score, 8.3. 8.8. We got an 8.9. We got an 8.9. And we got another 8.9. All right, and that's a total score of a 26.1. Y'all give him some love, though. Give him some love. All right, last up, last group up, round one. Y'all give it up for the other team. We got an 8.9. Woo! We got an 8.9. Woo! We have a 9.1. We have a 9.2. We got a 10. All right, that is a total score of a 27.2. Y'all show them some love. All right, I gotta do this, all right. Shout out to my Zoes. All right, so, I'm gonna translate this, but Kunya nou pal gen moun ki pal performe pou kon yo.
Right, anybody has some boots perform?
That means now we're gonna have all our people who are going to perform individually. Poetic Lyricism had an indie slam last Friday. These are our finalists. They're gonna be battling each other for the indie slam competition, all right? So y'all show some love for Jonathan, first to the mic.
Chilling with my friends. Figuring we had 5 minutes to go get some snacks, kind of eating. I'm not going to say what for, but fuck it. They had munchies, I just wanted them little s'mores. But anyway, being that Bullseye is not in our proximity, we declare Target's not our target, that we're going to Walmart. 5 minutes in, we each had all that we needed, but it took us 30 minutes to get to the checkout, because on the way back, for some reason, everything we saw, we felt the need to check out. And I'm like, that's a mental technique that gives the shopper to buy more. That's why the most common things need to locate in the back of the store so you pass items of interest that you're not in here for. See, Walmart's presence is often followed by desolence, leaving mom and pop stores irrelevant. Now, I can go on for days about this franchise's malevolence, like how employees seem to be paid or hired, more or less, on their past experience in boat hopping or scaling a fence, so wages paid are no problem because it's pennies earned, no millions earned when only a penny is spent. But I'm here to talk about the mistreatment that is ours. Why is it every time we're in line, for hours? I mean, rhythm. You guys have 50 lanes and only decide to open up 3. Lines backed up the toiletries and then try to put minds at ease by sending a trainee to lane 3 and how Brett's Facebook gets his login key still doesn't add up to me. I mean, the old man at the door should twist and be saying, "Welcome to Walmart. You can check out anytime you like, but you can never leave." I bet if Walmart hired a person for every register, unemployment could cease to be. An astonishing rise in the GDP is stimulating enough growth to stimulate the economy. But instead, I'm in a long-ass line behind a kid that beats his mommy, in line for so long that this should be considered hazing, overly excessive waiting, mentally being battled by Big Brother Smiley Face Almighty! With that ball, useless facing, same, ball by March. But most of the times I'm really just mad because I only got 3 items in my cart. And Maria, who know I've lightened legs, acts like she can't read 2 items for less than, like, bitch, you can't pull up those fists. We go to Walmart because I don't ever want to go to Wally World again. Because it's not a club for ass-shaking girls, rather an unamusement park that if you enter any day, you're coming out after dark. Been here for so long that I start questioning things in my life, like, should I really have taken 6 fucking classes? Or what would my life be like if I had a dad and other shit I've been through? To the point where this is driving me mental to the where I'm considering suicide with this kid's colored pencil. And it hits me. If waiting for the birds and these lines seem like the bees, why don't I just fucking leave?
All right, scores. Low is the highest, We have a 8.6. We got an 8.6. We got an 8.7. We got a 9. We got a 9.7. For a total score of 26.3. Y'all show them some love. All right, next to the mic, give it up for Andre.
Oh, hey, Andre! Have you ever noticed how the intangible things are what we hold on to the most? And right now, my hands have turned white from clenching onto the air for so long, grasping for my memories. The other day, I was having a conversation with my grandfather. He was telling me about a time he had met a queen, how in Spain the future monarchs are picked by the power of the familiar and how beautiful they are. He told me that as a poor street nomad, he had handed her his heart so she had something real to take where she was going so she wouldn't feel so quite alone at night. And despite my extreme disbelief in his story, I decided to share the wealth, telling him about a time I had met a queen, not knowing whether to start from describing her every detail, from each place curl in her hair to that twinkle in her eye, that even coming from a piece of dismantled coal to a divine diamond, a little less rough, maybe how she's inked down her back and back at her wrist with pictures that depict her life. I tell him that God must have molded her out of the clouds, fused the hues of cocoa and coffee beans together. I said, Lord, please excuse my blasphemy, but I think you might have created a modern day memory, and right now, I hope everything truly happens for a reason. She was more than a season here to weather my storm. I never knew that angel wings came in the form of ligaments, a halo to match that tongue of fire. Abuelo, have you ever seen someone catch the caution you tossed in the wind, floating mid-air? Thank you, Cloud Nine. She sucks in light to attain a new mindset. I swear, her energy is a new type of high. She can walk past Medusa's severed head, make the eyes blink, making us another set of two stone lovers. I brag to him about how we slow dance under the stars in silence to our own melody. She expressed to me she wished she could dance with her fathers just one last time, and with the clock counting down into departure, we were cramming to share one last rhyme. I told her all I want to do is save and change lives. She said, well, at least change mine. I said, mi amor, don't fret. Don't stress. Notice it's always princesses, never queens, that are damsels in distress. Yes, I ask God to make sure the sun and moon never part. I hope this night never departs. I think we are reciprocal pieces of the same heart. She said, if this is gonna end badly, then why start? And I just held her, lingered in a linguistic lip lock with no intentions to ever part, and I would expand. But this is not a love poem. It's a testimony. Cherish those special moments in your life, because memories are the leaves on your life tree, falling and then traveling into the depths of the earth. So hold on tight, because one day it might be you clenching the air to your hands turn white, because memories will slip from your palm and evaporate from your life.
All right, scores. Calm down, y'all. All right, scores. Low is the highest. We got a 9.8. We got a 10. And we got a 10. All right. We're about to bring up the next performer. Quick shout out to guest services. Please don't cut the lights off on us. You back there. somebody got to say it. Shame on. All right, what's the total? All right, total score 29.6. Y'all show some love. All right, next to the mic, y'all show some love for Melissa.
Ooh, Melissa.
Every time we touch, I get this feeling, and it never fails to send my body reeling back to a time when I could barely rhyme and I didn't know the definition of childhood stealing. Every time you touch me, I get this feeling. I was 7. Yes, only 7. Not knowing the difference between hell and heaven, but knowing enough to know that this was wrong. Oh, listen to this song. A ring of fire manifested itself around me as he trailed up my jeans with the end of his little slugger bat, going on and on about this or that, grinning like the Cheshire Cat till he made contact. Stop! Don't touch me there! That is my no-no square! R-A-P-E, R-A-P-E, rape. He did not rape me, but still he managed to change me. And I get so weak in the knees I can hardly speak when I think of him caressing me, testing me, ripping off his belt, beating on the bunk bed frame, demanding that I call out his name like he was my savior. Please, somebody save her, the little girl that I used to be. Before I transformed into this mess that is me, she used to drink well milk every night before bed. But now, for obvious reasons, instead, she just sips on her tears, wallowing in her fears, hiding in the pit of my stomach, hunkered down low. Now she's just somebody that I used to know. One who'll never be able to cry out rape or to utter that man's name every time we touch. I get this feeling. I open my eyes and stare up at the ceiling, searching for answers I know aren't there. Like, where does he get off existing in my past and fucking up my future? His fingertips linger like wounds that won't be sutured. And I swear, forever is one day when I forget these memories, because never will I know a woman's worth until I'm free from this woman's curse. He did not steal my innocence, but borrowed it and never brought it back. He still left my virginity intact, but still, I do not love out of friendships and one-night stands, but I want to. I cannot stare into the eyes of any man, but I must. Still, I shudder at your touch, because molestation is just enough. So every time we touch, I'll get that feeling. And it won't be justified, but please, blame it on the man who passed me by and stole all of me. Every ounce, except for the cherry that society counts.
Check. All right, y'all. Real quick. I just want to say on behalf of the men in the room, I know it's very hard for a lot of us to understand what y'all go through as women. So I want all the men in the room to give y'all a round of applause. All right, we're gonna go on to the scores from lowest to highest. We have we got a 9.1. We got a 9.1. We have a 9.5. We have a 9.7. And we have a 10. All right, for a total score of a 28.3. Y'all show Melissa some love. All right, we'll keep it moving next to the mic. Y'all give it up for Elle.
I watched my mother give my father all the things that were meant for her alone. Sacrifice flesh and shadow, the erectness of her spine even, anything at all to keep him. Eve was built from the right rib of Adam, and it was as if my mother felt guilty of the exchange, so tore into herself daily just to offer my father a piece of her structure as apology. And no matter how many times her bedroom was painted starless in his absence or reeked of other women that did not belong to him, my mother would offer herself again and again, depleting every resource she could find until all that was left was a spine that couldn't remember what it was made for, and three children who would never learn how to love. I will never wish to be my mother. To be so built in man that I forget my hands are carpenter enough. Mommy, black men are not blacksmiths, just black bulls in China stores, smashing all the porcelain dolls that barely belong to them. I learned too soon the value of a broken body's language, how backs wrap like willow tree trunks, trying to find fingertips fit to fix them. Wow. I sat on a granite rock with my first love a few nights ago. trying to remember why he chose me once, and then again he kissed me like I still glittered to him, but I could only taste all the poison of my mother's leftover self-pity, the vision of her clipped wings, and the fear that his hands would be the shears to clip my own mommy. I realize we are two women afraid of our own reflection. Both steering clear of mirrors, scared to see what one man has made of the two of us. No, everything broken cannot be fixed, but even fixed stones can be broken. I wish we had learned the right lessons once he left us, that women are made in psalms and chapters in the Bible, and no man can be my religion unless he first learns my verses. Get the fuck up from your bed of broken glass. Shine radiant once again. Be the queen a king could never afford. You are the sea that reigns over 1,000 shores. You are a key that unlocks 1,000 doors. Be my example that our hands are always carpenter enough.
All right, we got the scores. Lowest to highest, lowest to highest. We have a 8.9. We have a 9.0. We got a 9.7. We got a 9.8. And we have a 10. For a total score of a 28.5. Y'all show Elson love. All right, final indie poet to the mic. Final indie poet to the mic. Y'all show some love for Ephraim.
When kids snap, they running through your halls with a gun, click clack, vengeance in their eyes, they looking for payback, ha! When kids snap, they running through your halls with a gun, click clack, vengeance in their eyes, they looking for payback, stay back, or else you get capped too. Cause where were you when my whole back was bruised trying to shield myself from the punches? Stay back. Don't try to touch me, because where were you all those days I had to go home hungry? Damn bullies keep stealing my bag lunches. I tried to tell administrators I thought that was smarter, but telling doesn't make it stop. Just makes it hit harder. Even if you do tell on that one dude, he has a crew, so when the smoke clears, he's replaced by another goon. So now, it's my turn. I'm about to go get him, put it click. I'm about to go kill him. I know they'll see me as a villain, but I'm really a hero when he goes. Him and everybody else, they egg him on with laughter, with cheers. They got a rush out of my tears, but with this trigger, it's over when I apply pressure for my peers. This whole year, I've been viewed as lame, loner, loser, or so weird, but I feel with this steel, I'ma be the most feared. I walk into school with the death stare. I know who's gonna get got, where they hang out, and what time they get there. I want them to beg for me to go away the same way I did to them. Then I want them to cry with bloodshot eyes, and then I want them to die their life in my palm like God, but I'm not. Cause that would imply that I'll have some sort of mercy on you. No, you must go. The bell rang and now it's time to start the show. Mask on, shots rang out. They don't know who's holding the heat. I remember you laughing at me, bang, bang, go to sleep. Don't pray now because he has forsaken you like you did me. Dump the clip out on the hallway and reload up this empty mask off when I confront my bully. I remember all those times you pushed me, embarrass me in front of my crush, clown me to look cool in front of your friends, but you are such a tough guy when the slugs fly goodbye. And there he was, finally defeated. But seeing that there was no way out this mess, I turned the gun to my head. When kids snap, they are the neglected. They take matters into their own hands, devise a plan, and people end up on a death list. I guess it's them trying to tell us something, a warning
comes before destruction, but yet we never read that message.
Oh, meet with the street, with the street, with the slash.
All right. Scores, lowest to highest. We got an 8.9. Hey, pull him again, 8.9. I'm down. We got a 9.2. We have a 9.6. We have a 9.9. And we have a 9.9. So Mr. Ephraim, that is a total score of a 28.7. Y'all show Ephraim some love. All right, we're about to go into round two of our group. Poetry Slam groups, y'all are gonna go in the same order in round two, okay? Same order. Hope you remember it. Real quick, I'm kind of like walking around during the show. I want to give a quick shout out to the youngest member in our audience. He's 9 years old in the back of the room with his older brother, Pernell. Give it up for Jabari. He's back there. Good experience, man. Oh, okay. Well, we're going to try to keep this show rolling really quick because they're here to shut us down. He's just doing his job, y'all. He's just doing his job. All right, so let me look at the list real quick. All right, first up, we have Operation Face. Operation Face.
That validation and confidence up. Cookie cutter shorts. Along with that high school tummy top that's so under that.
I'm giving you
top, and I love that tri-color lace front. Me and her, we hit the strip club and make it rain child support. Yeah, in fact, I ain't even seen my own child in about 4 months. But it's cool though. I still wake up in the morning talking about something. Wake up, bake up, tweet about getting my cake up. Wake up, bake up, tweet about getting my cake up. Wake up, bake up, tweet about getting my cake up. Doing good and well, I live fairly well off of welfare.
Hey, you heard the one about Action Negro?
Nah, what about
it? Check this out. Wind it up, and it doesn't work.
Damn, that's something else. That they talk about our people. Yes, our people. Knowing that we only account for 23%. Bamboozled. You have been bamboozled to believe the stereotypes portrayed in today's media are conducive to your well-being or your behavior. But damn, I love me some white bitches. If I get another one in the apartment, on the couch, on the carpet, rolling around like two animals in a harsh grip, biting on one another till the love drips, I'ma die. My heart skips a beat every time we sleep in. I suppose that's the reason I show up late, because I have to. And while I'm at work, I go in the back and get high in the back room. Then I'm dipping out early to go to my homie's car that lacks calf room. It's my favorite part of the day. We smoking weed, we got fried chicken, and we about to rap too. Nigga, give me a beat. Paid a booze in a pimped out Gucci suit. Ain't had no job, but I still fly. I got everything in my mama's name. But that's alright, cause I still fly.
Yo, the money that I make when I do work, I give a portion to the church. Okay. The rest is used to make our twerk.
Yeah.
I just wanna see that beauty verse. Watch on him my duty space. You mean I gotta bend my back to pull up someone else's slack? Nigga, I can't even pull up my pants! Not a damn chance! There must be nicotine in my wallet, cause I'm addicted to the money. It's in my brain, it's on my veins, I'm making rain till it's money. The only women I respect are bartenders. Why? They got fat asses, they don't talk much, and they hand me hard liquor. Oh, and for the ladies, I got a rap with the size of Tallahassee that I'm making similar to the game of chop.
So
So in turn, the only faces that we should judge by are the faces that we put upon ourselves. Because if Richard Pryor, Paul Mooney, and Dave Chappelle taught me one thing, it's the best comedian is the one who can get you to laugh at yourself. Black face. It's been
All right. Shout out to ADHD in the house. All right, scores, lowest to highest. We have a 8.5. Horrible score, Mike. We have an 8.9. We have a 9.2. A 9.3. And a 9.6. For a total score of a 27.4. Y'all show them some love. Next up to the mic, representing FSU, y'all show some love for Stereotype.
They watch war.
Political figures, into class, even bullying, but instead of learning defense, I'd rather learn the wonders of the Fibonacci sequence. The pretense to me graduating is my GPA. Eating block food, they surprised, they trying to change my DNA. Man, I wish I could go back and put my life on replay, but I'm stuck to sit in the class, listening to he say, she say.
And I try to track back all these history facts, all these bloodlines lost of the natives in black. These must be those red lines that be striping the flag and call the other man back. How you reconcile that? You know that they appease Hitler till they let him get caught. Guess never forget to supply to those certain atrocities and the patriot that take our rights for security clearance. All the American principles died, now it's all disappearing.
It's almost time for class, gotta learn my history. Take over from my past, all I learned was misery. They cover up our holidays, Thanksgiving in November. You mask to the race and it seems no one remembers. Pretenders of discovery, they make us praise Columbus. My presence of disease and race, always teaches the toughest. Pockets teaches science, in our culture knowledge. Pirates teaches English, that makes silence, make us robots, why not right? If we use slang, it's a grammatical error. They repress our right brain, that's strategic. Good, yeah. They say calm seas don't make the skill. Say the must be why they make it tough for us to live without the paper. Please.
Call the truth, poet!
Keep it rolling. All right, scores. Respect the mic. All right, scores. Lowest to highest, we got a 7.6. We have an 8.0. We have an 8.2. We have an 8.7. And we have a 9.4. For a total score of a 24.9. Y'all show Stereotype some love. Next up to the mic. Give it up for 18.
Back in the day when I was young, I'm not a kid anymore. But some days I sit and wish I was a kid again. Because in adolescence,
Your dreams are in their purest form.
Colossal! I could cut them up and tie them into a lasso that would stretch around any burning planet. Pull it straight to my heart because they say a star is a burning planet. When I was a child, my heart was a burning planet.
I want to be an astronaut, able to examine flying rocks, watch them pass by swiftly, speeding past the stars, going from planet to planet.
And I want to teleport because my dream couldn't be deferred. It was like a pearl, precious and rare. And if anyone tried to take it away from me, I would clutch it tight with two hands as if I was choking the life out of imagination. Our dreams are all we had. When we were younger, they were massive enough to fill up the Atlantic Ocean. As we aged, they're putting the sink with the drain open.
I want to learn to hold on to my dreams, because as frustrating as it seems, they're all I have to avoid insanity. I'd rather be trapped in an asylum
and have my dreams confined by a marriage straitjacket.
Is as infinite as we can imagine, expanding this perspective is what it just mankind focus on, conquering our true enemies, the formidable foes, ignorance and limitations.
Our minds were virgins in a world of nymphomaniacs. I wish I could bring those days back when I didn't think with my genitals and cartoons worked subliminal.
Mama said you gotta know the difference between time and space, relating to weeks, months, and even years that interface.
The phase of going back home never felt so great.
That real museums are places where time is transformed into space. All I need is time and space to reach my dreams.
This plan was set in stone, but now society's conforming my plan like Plato into a structure that they see fit.
But who said I need an architect to explain my own blueprints? Don't be alarmed, this is taking me into the event like a bad AC. Most of you sit in your seats and watch our dream change quicker than Florida weather, quicker than the living situations of proud Africans when they were stripped from their homeland.
My God, it's a shame to see a dream be lost in the cloud, because we'll never get it back.
That's right.
I finally found the direction to my dream, and they're telling me the lane's closed.
Why they turn us against our dreams?
Give us hope.
And let us soar above the clouds.
And help wrap these dreams in our head and imaginations and light them like we're hotboxing in our brains with a rainbow.
But I'm not an astronaut.
And I'm not a teleporter.
Just something practical.
But that's not a dream. In order for it to be a dream, it has to consume your every thought.
Our childhood desire has broken out of society's asylum.
And we'll forever protect them with our lives, because our dreams deserve to stay alive.
And without them, we, ourselves, would die.
Back in the day when I was young, I'm not a kid anymore, but some days I say I wish I was a kid again.
All right, scores, 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 lowest and highest. We have an 8.2. We have an 8.8. We have an 8.8. We have an 8.9. And we got a 9. All right, so that's 18. That's a total score of a 26.5. All right, with us being Poetic Lyricists, we'd like to give shout-outs to other performing arts organizations. I want to give a shout-out to an organization who won a step competition not too long ago, representing FAMU. Y'all give it up for people. All right. Also representing FAMU, next up to the mic, y'all give it up for Estrogen.
Amen. Christians believe in church, man. Thank you, Jesus. And then it happened.
wonder why it's so hard to bring people closer to God, why some artists get more praise than Jesus.
And it's ridiculous how people are more moved by the work of man.
Worshiping beats and lyrics that can tear their soul.
They want silver and gold instead of eternal life.
So in the sense they really do live by,
YOLO
albums have become the new King James versions of the Bible. We got gospel artists dropping beats like secular artists.
Gospel music isn't supposed to make me want
to
dance.
It's supposed to make me want to throw up my hands and thank God for lifting me up, turning me around while placing my feet back on the floor.
We got a 9.1. We got a 9.1. We got a 9.7. We have a 9.9. And we have a 10. All right, that's a total score of a 28.7. Y'all show Estrogen some love. Final group to the stage for round two. Y'all give it up for the other team.
Nigga. And she likes to murder roses, tearing petals from nests. And
insecurities, my fears, because my lack of trust
can only mean that I can't trust myself to bear the scar of living. So I write on my wrist like an artistic color, left behind to survive in this unbalanced world.
Alone.
Trapped. Empty. But so, so full of passion. Though it's slowly being crushed by this lack of trust.
So I lust. Allow myself to be used for the satisfaction of a woman's smile.
So I can't wonder my love no longer lives here.
As I start quitting these dreams, because how can I trust without loving and love without trusting?
The path is so unclear in this gothic fantasy. Feeling like a raven in the night, Aquarella Poe, the author to my dreams. What if they guide me like the sound of an African drum? Allow the vibrations of an epiphany to run through me. Enemy steps through the heaven, I have the strength of the almighty Zeus.
Because I'm a god born to fly.
Understanding that if I get it set behind,
exactly what I was talking about. Or if Kurt Franklin did that. 2 Chainz. Shut up. Scores. Lowest and highest. We have an 8.5. We have an 8.6. We have a 9.8. We have a 9.8. And we have a 10. That is a 28.2. Now we're going into our final round for our indie poets, and then we're gonna go into the final round for the group poets, all right? So these are the indie poets that made the cut. First of all, I want y'all to make some love for all the poets. Show some love for all the poets. Thank you. First up to the mic, one of our finalists. Y'all give it up for Mr. Andre.
First pillar of my quest for self-love. This is where mean words mean less than your 2 cents. Your nuisance is nauseating, and I've up just enough uppercuts to say, this is revenge of the weirdo. I'm weird, so don't be fooled by the unsure smile and the catcall in the wind. I'm coming with arrows similar to Cupid, just a lot less loving the first targets. The kids in high school who thought it was cool to act like everyone else. You guys are as generic as Walmart cereal brand. Even though you call yourself Cocoa Roos instead of Cocoa Puffs, you're still Cocoa Puffs, just in a different box. Don't patronize me, cause I tend not to fit into a box. Labeling me is like trying to fit Shaq and Yao Ming in a mini coupe. It's just not happening, and I'm getting cooped up in this cage. So let me spread my eagle wings and show you how my feathers grow. I'm 18 years old. I'm trying to find God in my mistakes with my family when it comes to art. Usually I take the cake, adolescence I blossom late. Spend most days trying to crawl from my own skin. Now my self-esteem is a little too high. I've turned the word weird into a synonym for too sexy. And I know I'm not a perfect 10, but sometimes you gotta believe that you're a 9.99. Because if you don't, who will? So know that I got this young face because I'm filled with boyish charm. And I got a bird chest because I'm fly. Both my clothes are so I don't really rock the jump, man. I'm sorry, Mr. Jordan. It's not that I can't afford your shoes. It's just I don't like looking like everyone else. But much love to your hustle. Exploiting black people is genius. I'm mad. I didn't think of it. But if I ever do decide to fall into the hype, I'll make sure to give you a call. Your shoes will look back, look nice with my snapback jean jacket and cargoes. Like, you want individualism? Nah, YOLO. Mr. Frost is right. The road less traveled was meant to be traveled solo. Here we go again. I got a small group of friends who are eclectic enough to put up with my weird quirks. Like, I like peanut butter and pickle sandwiches just as much as I love girls who twerk wild and natural hair keep me sane. Cause I'm as chaotic as two planes and a suicide bombing nosedive. My music takes ranges from Lupe to Cool Cup. I move my feet to Flying Lotus. I blast Black Hippie and Chief Keef. I Chief Leaf to Keep Peace. My favorites are Wolf Haley and Gambino. They taught me how to just be me. And even at night, I'll still play Frank Ocean. The hell if he's gay. I'll always yell at the top of my lungs. A tornado flew around my room before I came. I used to think that you were a tornado, but now I know I'm a hurricane. Don't get caught in my outskirts. To be safe, look me in my eye. No. Look me in my eyes. Fathom that the people that judge you most are your own blood. Just being me equates to your love. Mama tells company, don't pay him no mind. He's just weird. Little brother says I dress like a faggot. Grandma asked me to please, please, just try to fit in. Don't stand out too much. Worried I might not make it. It's just being me. But it's just being me is the greatest thing I can think to be. I was blessed with the light of the sun, but common misconceptions cause eclipses. This is not as much as a revenge as it is redemption.
Scores. Respect the mic, audience. Respect the mic. Alright, scores. Lowest and highest. We have 8.8. Alright. Dang, she said what? Alright, we got a 9.7. 9.7. A 10. Now, unfortunately, there was a time deduction, so your score is a 28.9. Y'all can contest that. 28.9. So you want to check with the scorekeeper over here. All right, next up to the mic, y'all show some love for L.
Nobody ever told me that unloving your own temple is religion too. No one says bodies are built in bone but break in more ways than one, that your confidence is a bent spine curving its way around your thoughts, that sometimes the bathroom scale is the only god you need, and mirrors are but shards of glass taunting the blue veins of your wrist, the curve of your hips, your lips, and all other things you wish you could break free from already. You can hate yourself so well, it's become an art form. The symmetrical shape of bruises from pressing yourself together, they look a little like saints the way they ring and sting, but make you feel alive. At least you've raped the shape out of your thighs for so long, the diamonds to dust. How holy can you be when filled with so many holes? You rise with the sun, wishing last night was your last night, because here you are taking up too much space in that empty bed of yours again. I know what a body battle feels like. The cuts and scrapes to shape your shape, cut and paste those pictures, girl. You too can be beautiful. God don't just come in threes, he comes in twos if you want him to. When that body is only 2 fingers away, or 2 miles every 2 days, or 2 months, no food, just celery and water every 2 hours. I've worshipped them all, those diet deities that can't hear me pray, just chant. Don't you want to be a size 2 too? reminded of those childhood summers when everyone wore shorts but you. How do you love the roly-poly mess you've made of yourself? How do you walk so light yet weigh so heavy, the tail skip tits low? Do you hold your head high? How? Tell me how. The willows heard me weeping one night, crunched in a corner, trying to smooth away all my imperfections, body bruised like a soldier who's seen too many wars. They passed me to Mother Nature, who stripped me naked and sat me by the sea. Look, she said, you look just like me. All my mountains and deserts and rivers run through you, my darling. You are beautiful too. You are a northern star with southern charm. It's from east to west. Don't you dare curse those cardinal curves. You are an embodiment of my earth, girl. My sun sets on the tips of those teeth and rises in those irises. Don't you dare loathe the clay fortress I have given you. See how men praise all the rough and rugged parts of me, even the brilliance of my belt, my backside. Love begins and ends in the folds of my skin. Find yourself here. You were built here. You belong here too. The next morning, I woke up naked. There was sand in my hair, clay in my palms. The sun rose in my eyes, and all seven of my stretch marks were smiling.
Scores. All right, scores. Lowest to highest. We're almost done. Lowest to highest. We have a 9. All right, to this. We got a 10. A 10. All right, poets, y'all make sure y'all watch the time. She also had a 0.5 deduction for time. But, total, we gotta respect the rules. Total, she got a 29.5, so y'all show us some love, 29.5. All right, our final indie poet of the evening. Y'all show him some love. Give it up for Ephraim.
I was that dude that was too cool for lame, but too lame for cool. Not cocky and aloof enough to be a cool kid, but not outlandish and quirky enough to be different. Just average at first glance. No, I do not have bands to make you dance. Just poetry under moonlight and romance, my style. May not be the most advanced. Never been one to sag my pants. Never walked into a room and had all the ladies in a trance. Just average at first glance. Nothing's worse than that. Especially when walking with two of your best friends who are stylish, aloof, quirky, outlandish, all at the same time, and have people look right through me. Miss the cellophane again. Have to build my name again. The more things change, the more they seem to stay the same again. There was a sun seemingly sewn inside my soul, so I have to hand them off some shades again just so they can stop looking at me so blindly. God, I know you are putting me through my season of humility to remind me that even heroes are not recognized on first appearance. So hear this, my pride is a sandcastle during high tide. The only thing keeping me from being a nobody of thoughts, of lyrics, and stanzas in my mind. Why does it have to be this way? Why do I need this stage to eat this page, not to feel this way like I am a poem away from irrelevant? Why can they see that I was the same dude with words of life before the mic? They ignore my light until I put them something in front of something with a cause, and they that restore the sight of fact. And itself reminds me not to write because the dorm is night, but because there's more to write, because there's more to light. It's sort of like, oh, I have to prove myself all the time. Now I'm not attracted. with my poetry. I am a good person. I just wish that I didn't always have to prove what my worth is. But if this is what's on my plate, without fail, I will prove that I am great. I just hate the fact that everyone's taking for granted that I have what it takes.
Scores. We have a, y'all give it up, we have a 9. We have a 9. We have a 9.2. We have a 9.5. And we have a 9.8. All right, that's a 27.7. Give them some love. Give them some love. This next part is very important. I want everybody to pay attention because we are over on time. 10 o'clock deadline is 10:10. So we are about to do the final round of the poetry slam for the groups. Unfortunately, we cannot be in here. Unfortunately. Right, Karen? What?
You gotta be done, right? It's cold. Like this.
Alright, well, unfortunately, I don't think it can be in here. So, what we're gonna do, we have 3 more performances. Can y'all hold on for 3 more performances? Make some noise if you can. Alright. So, we got 3 more performances. And, Aaron, we need to clear the room. Alright, so we got 3 more performances. So, listen up very carefully, y'all. Very carefully. Because y'all need to know who the winners are going to be tonight. We owe them that respect. So I want everybody to relocate. We're going to go downstairs. Y'all know where the auditorium is? Right downstairs. We're going to go to the courtyard. I want everybody standing in the courtyard. Poets, y'all up on stage. We're going to end it right there. We got 3 more performances. That's about 15 minutes. Let's relocate real quick so that they can flip the room real quick, y'all.
Second team to make it to the finals. Give it up for Estrogen. All right, and our final team to make it to the finals, give it up for the other team. All right. So, this side, quiet down, y'all. Stop pointing. Hey, man, I see it all. Stage presence. All right. All right, so we're outside, so it's very important that everybody keep quiet. Let's hold your applause till after the performance, because it's very hard to perform outside, all right? First team up is going to be the A team. Go ahead and make some love for them. Thank you.
That's my grandma voice.
They always ask me why we did it. And I tell them that it's a story that needs to start from the beginning.
I run up on them with a chopper,
Hit the deck if you value your life.
Tell the security guards if we don't want the odds of death to become an amputee. Disarm yourself. All of our hearts bound to unison like a chorus of timpanies.
Hoping that nobody was feeling like Jesus that day, sacrificing themselves for the sake of the people.
Palms wetter than hurricanes in Miami.
The rust of adrenaline pumping through my veins.
Urge my hands to quicken.
These thoughts excite me. To be frank, it never rains in Southern California unless I pull the trigger, leaving an ocean of unnecessary spilled blood.
Click, clack, attention shots fired. Innocent people died to the ground like suicide on 9/11. We have a bag and we don't want to buy it, just the dough.
So this first shot is for the cold.
Hurry up and crack the safe so we can go.
Lock, load, and explode on any man in our way because there's no time to waste.
Yes, because time is money, right?
And I need this money.
Oh God, give me some more time.
The clock's racing my heart to see who can go the fastest. 20 minutes left. Screams pierce the air.
A little girl is drowning in her own blood.
He claims she was making too much noise.
We ain't got time. Everyone's a threat.
My mother's breathless words creep to my ear and she says, pray for me.
But mama, I've been praying every day.
Learn to use this Glock and tuck your heart in and show it through your vest.
How does he not know that? 6-year-old girls haven't learned to choke down their emotions yet.
If you got a problem how I'm running things, we can split this money 3 ways.
I don't know which one weighs more, this gun or the monkey on my back.
My future's behind these steel walls and it's mine for the taking. Waving this gun, trying to scare some people.
And not noticing the fear in me.
But no matter how steel-like I seem, these peers from my peers is pressure.
The safe is open with the enough money to make Donald Trump rethink his business plan.
I need this!
These streets got me hungry. You guys acting like some prostitutes. Don't blow this job for me.
Calm down, kid.
I was fan ignorance until I was sick to the stomach. Now I'm throwing it back up because nobody's coming between me and this money.
I've got this clock already fast.
They told me to reach for the 9 like I'm too fast, Paul.
Stop swimming through the air like flying fish. SWAT team swarm the scene like bees looking for the queen.
They're a threat to the dream, so let me go ahead and off them before they ruin my chance to succeed. I need my art to mean something. I can't do that from starving in the street.
It was in slow mo, but I swear now. I was in 10 speed.
Bullseye.
Mama lost a son.
Is this really something I wanted to do?
Bullets are coming to give my face a kiss goodnight. Is there any way to escape my demise?
The body count is at full. I never wanted anybody to die during my proven ground period, much less my crew. Sirens bring my hands to surrender. If only we figured out that it wasn't worth it. They always ask me why we did it. And the saddest part about it is, I don't even know, because I can't even tell you myself.
All right, for a total score of a 28, show us some love. All right. Next up, I want y'all to show some love for these women. Y'all give them some love. Give it up for Estrogen.
Warning, the following contains explicit content.
I got an ass so big like the sun.
Hope you got a mouth for a dick I wanna run.
Slap it in the face, shove it down the throat.
What? I thought y'all was strong women.
We are strong women, and I'm looking for a strong man to deplete all this estrogen.
Y'all know I'm a lady in the streets, but a freak in the sheet.
Yeah, but here's something I can't understand. A guy can have one wife, a mistress, and a girlfriend, but if I want to creep and try to keep it on the down low, he get all mad and now he calling me a hoe.
Dudes always want my ass to the sky and my face to the floor.
But I be taking Missy's advice.
Pussy don't fail me now.
Playing in the cockpit, strap him down, cover his mouth, because I don't want to hear shit. When I'm in the boom-boom room, there ain't no confusion. He know I'm a sergeant.
And I'ma ride that dick like a soldier. Got my legs strapped to your holster. Sex in the morning is the best part of waking up like vultures.
Don't eat too much, I might choke you.
I just want to make love. I remember this one guy, ooh, Lord. Strong muscles, long legs, and a long, well, anyway. He put the test in testosterone. Who knew you could get a grade A stroke by giving good D? Our rhythm was melodic, and when we climaxed together, the beat suddenly stopped, and all you heard was,
ah, on the track, ick it on the track, ick it on the track.
I like the way music used to be. Everything that happened between me and my baby stayed
between the sheets.
The Isley Brothers? I prefer those 90 gritty hip-hop beats.
Man, I want some R&B. I want some tweets. Ooh, there goes my kids all over your face. Oh, my.
What happened to equal opportunity? Dudes be brave. look, he didn't even leave a scratch. Niggas be like, ooh, baby, you feel that?
No!
Discretion is advised.
I'ma grab that
beep,
put it in my
beep, beep, beep.
For an hour, beat me over in the shower. Boy, I want you to
beep. What she meant to say was, I want to take possession of your penis and insert it into my bag. For an hour, I would like to have sexual intercourse in the shower. Boy, I want to
beep.
Straight like that.
My mind is telling me no. As a lady, I'm not supposed to let my sexual desires known. But that's just what society says. Because if my body is telling me yes, don't judge me if I'm trying to get this feeling off my chest.
Can you hold my legs while you smacking my ass?
And I'ma lay on my back while you play with this cat.
And I'ma pull you deep and hold you forever. I don't want this moment to pass.
Sex is a beautiful thing,
and women deserve to enjoy it too.
So I'ma say what I want.
And if I sound a little blunt,
don't judge me for trying to be me.
Speaking my mind doesn't make me more or less of a lady.
I'm just giving you directions on how to please me.
Plus, y'all know.
Y'all love it.
When we talk dirty.
All right. Scores. Low is the highest. We got a 9.5. We got a 9.8. We got a 10.
So happy.
All right. That's 29.8. If you're on this side and you can't hear, you might want to move to the middle. All right, give it up for the final team of the night. Y'all show some love, representing FAMU. Give it up for the other team.
Let's go!
I don't know if you ladies are aware or not, but you're currently looking at the equivalent of E.L. James's 50 Shades of Grey in the flesh. And the way some of y'all are looking skeptical, it lets me know that it must be true. You judge me by my cover without checking out my summary, so your eyes only go by what your mind can see. I'm starting to believe that don't judge a book by its cover. It's one of the most unused pieces of advice that's ever given, especially since everyone stresses the importance of a first impression, and I'm never enough, because your ideal man is 6 foot, physically buff, and resembles Morris Chestnut. And since I don't fit into your fairy tale roles, I'm considered to be something less. This is the problem I face on an everyday basis, being underestimated. But me constantly trying to fit in the constraints of your common standards limits my personality's exponential growth to its full potential. But the only reason why this ignorance is significant is because when it's repetitive, you start to accept it. But I'm telling you, reject it. Don't let someone's overview limit your way of living. You are more than capable of overachieving the low standards set by an individual's comprehension of your own appearance, especially if those assumptions are incoherent. Because since when does having a small body frame mean no gain? And wearing glasses means, oh, he must get straight A's in all his classes. No, I wear glasses because I can't see. Because your views are kind of big, because I bet you met Superman before, just thought he was Clark Kent. So if you still don't get it, I got this new do you boo-boo rule I'm about to end. For all the ladies, straining thinking they had to be more submissive because a good man does not fall for a woman who stands her ground. Remember, the only time you should hold your head down is when you realize the weight of your crown is as heavy as any other woman. You wasn't trying to fit in this misogynistic fuse. Fuck that. Do you, boo-boo. For all the kids growing up with the misconception that where they live can only inspire and go in one direction, down, Come on, man. That's the idea of whites playing the minds of blacks, but they had to come up with a way to suppress what they lack understand. The hood is not where you're going. It's where you advocate where it sings, because it lets the surroundings hold its back. It's okay to pick up a book and not to get. It's not what's around you, y'all. It's what's in you. So let your oppressors talk to the lips turn black and blue. Reach for the gods and do you, boo. We beings can achieve anything far beyond what others' prejudgments see. So let's no longer live down to what others want us to be, because it's not what's around you, it's what's in you. Potential is not in the eyes of the beholder. It is possibilities was given to us by our molder. So if anyone tells you what your outside says you're to be, you can either turn on your TV and agree to everything you see, or you can listen to the world's sexiest man, me. But either way, be true to you. So do you, boo boo. Do you.
Let's go!
All right. Hey, teams, come up here.
I'm gonna do the scores for the last group.
All right. So scores, lowest to highest. I got a 9, I got a 9.1, and I got a 10. All right, ladies and gentlemen, show some love for the judges. I want y'all to give all of these performers a round of applause. And finally, because this has never happened before and y'all actually care to come out here, I want y'all to give yourselves a round of applause. Let me get my indie poets up.
There's a girl missing.
What the
hell
that?
Hey, yo,
L. All right, indie poets. All right, coming up in third place. Give it up for Ephraim. Coming up in second place, give it up for L. The winner of the 2012 Tallahassee Collegiate Poetry Slam. We're gonna go from third to first. All right, coming up in third place, y'all show some love for the other team. In second place, show some love for the A-team. everybody.